Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to talk about the best Minecraft One Piece mod ever. So this mod is called Mine Nomi. If I go into the screen, the UI, it has over 72 devil fruits, and all these devil fruits have unique moves. In fact, not only does it have devil fruits, it has haki. It has haki, and the best part is you spawn it. Mixes Minecraft with One Piece like always. So, just like Obelmon, you spawn, seems normal, and you will have to find one of these structures. Maybe not specifically these, but just any unique structure that is to the Mine Nomi mall. Hence, suppose for this structure, this is a marine small base. And if we enter it, it should be filled with marines. Okay, well, as I said, it should be having marines. So the main thing about this mod is it's basically caught up to basically One Piece all the way up to Wano, and that's here. Now I say it's all the way up to Wano, but Kaido's dragon fruit is not in the game yet. But that doesn't matter. We have so many cool devil fruits in the game. So, the best devil fruit, in my opinion, has to be the Gorogoro Nomi, aka Lightning. We also have Earthquake, we have Mera Mera, Hie Hie, Pika Pika, aka Light, Ice, and Fire, and so many more. Those are just to name a few. The best part, I'll say, of this mod is all the powers we get. So if I go to the Gorogoro Nomi, eat it. So if I use this Gorogoro Nomi, I will have all the powers you can see here. Spark Step, El Thor, Voltwari, Kari, Sango, Raigo, Voltamaru, and Logan Burnability. All of those I will show later in this video. Maybe not specifically for the Gorogoro Nomi, but I'll show the powers of some other fruits in this video. Now, let's get started on how to get started. To get started, we press R. Alright, so we just started a new world, and I'm going to show you how we get started. We press R, and this thing opens up, this map-like thing. So, the first thing we have is faction. In faction, we can do a random faction. Usually gets us pirate, but not always. We have the option of pirate, marine, bounty hunter, revolutionary army member, and of course, the first one, random. Now, you have to choose one. So, suppose for this one, pirate. And do not click finish. Do not click finish. Go to race. Again, this could be random, but the races we have are human, fishman, cyborg, mink, and of course, random. And same goes for fighting style. We can have swordsman, sniper, doctor, art of weather, which is basically Nami's fighting style, brawler, Luffy, blackleg, Sanji. So, if you're going by One Piece characters, Zoro, Usopp, Chopper, Nami, Luffy, Sanji. And those are the three ones we can go for. For race, I say if you're going for a devil fruit, do not choose fishman. It just lets you breathe underwater, and, well, the devil fruit does not let you swim. It's annoying. But if you're not going, fishman is really good. Cyborg, we'll just have to use Cola, which is an item I'll show you. And Mink, you become fast. I don't know why there's a dog version. And then, it doesn't matter really. Human is normal. Factions, pirate, marine, bounty hunter, revolutionary armor. Other than marine, most of these are just you're against the marines. I'm fighting style random. So if I click finish here, and then I click R again, you will notice that I am now a cyborg, that's a pirate, and I'm a sniper. Now, there's Doriki. Doriki is basically our power level. If we have a high Doriki, we are really strong. Low Doriki, really weak. So if I go into survival here, you will notice that I have only 20 hearts of HP. But if my Doriki is 10,000, that 20 hearts will become 250. So it will basically more than 10 times itself. It will get multiplied by more than 10. And the best part about Doriki is it also makes your move stronger. And we also have Haki in this game. Now, the best way I could show you Haki is if I go here. You don't get Haki naturally in the game. You will have to do a command. So you'll have to go /ability, unlock group, and then you'll have to spell out Haki, enter. Now, you will have all Haki that is present in the game. So if I press R, and if I go to abilities, I have this, which is my cyborg abilities, and then I have this, all the Haki, conquerors but worse, advanced observation. This is the Haki that you put on a sword, just strong Haki. All these are just different versions of Haki. Now you get started. You can defeat marines to get Doriki. You can also defeat pirates to get Doriki. The way you get the devil fruit is you'll have to find, like, suppose that ship in a chest. It might contain a devil fruit, but it is very, very rare. Now let me show you the powers of a devil fruit, just any devil fruit. Let's take Pika Pika Nomi, which is the light fruit, and I eat it. And now I press R, abilities. So this is my light fruit abilities, cyborg abilities, and now this is my Haki. So let's go for, and now we can get all the moves. So how you get the moves? You basically press one of these, just left click, and then you click this. It's that easy. And then Logia invulnerability is, as the name states, you are immune to every hit that does not have ornament Haki, and you can hit them back. See? And yeah, we can also have Haki, all this. It's really cool. You should explore Haki yourself, because there are lots, and I'm trying to make this video short. Yeah, this is what happens if you are a devil fruit user and you fall into water. You get weakness, mining fatigue, and slowness, and you go to the very bottom of the ocean and you can't swim back up. Now let me show you the abilities of the light fruit. If I click alt, now the way you get abilities, if you have to click left alt, now the bar, the red bar, you can see that's my cola. If you are a human or any race that is not cyborg, you will not have that. Cola is not necessary for devil fruits, but it is necessary for your cyborg abilities. Other than that, this is the first move, which basically just teleports you somewhere. Like that. Second move, that. Yeah, this mod is really destructive. So be careful of what you do. Now, as you can see, they have cooldowns for when you use them, which is good because some of them are really OP. Then we have the Ama no Murakoma, which is basically a light sword. You get a sword made of light. It also does lots of damage. Light is really good. And then we have Amaterasu, which I actually don't have anyone to test it on. 1 minute. Now, one problem, if you're in your combat mode, which is what happens if you press Alt, you cannot see your normal hotbar. Oh, alright. So, I just spawned in a Marine Admiral, who apparently has Haki, and I'm gonna show you what my move Amaterasu does. Yeah, I just one-shot him. And he had Haki. Now, let me show you one more thing. Where is it? Sorry. Yeah, we have our own advancements. So you can see Haki Master, Watsukorosuki, and then slightly modifying ship's design by exploding it, aka just subtle tweaks. And then Devil Fruits is just eat a Devil Fruit. You have your own achievements that are not a part of the mainline game. Priceless Blade, obtain a Supreme Grey Blade, Cat Burglar, 1,000 belly, 100,000 belly, blah, blah, blah. Now, that's only light. Now, one problem about this mod that I will say, if you eat a fruit, like if I eat a fruit right now, nothing is going to happen. The fruit is just wasted. But I'll have to die to eat another fruit. So if you're planning to use many fruits, do not, like in a survival playthrough, do not make a hardcore world. That's just really, really simple. Now, if I just do slash kill over here and take my personal favorite fruit, the Goro Goro Nomi, eat it. Press R. As you can see, I just got 22 Doriki. So if I go into survival, I'm pretty sure you'll need to get like 1,000 Doriki. But if you get a lot of Doriki, your health will start to change. Now I press R. Abilities. Spark Step. El Thor. Voltwari. Kari. Sango. Raigo. And Voltamaru. And it's also a Logia. So, you know, that's good. Alright, let me show you the first move. The first and the second move, in my opinion, can be used hand in hand. So, if I go up here and then I use El Thor, that's electric step, it teleports you up. And then El Thor does this. Yeah, it just summons a huge lightning bolt which destroys everything in this region. It looks so cool. Oh, and you take no fall damage because you're a Logia user. And the third move is another move that builds itself up, but it's not too powerful. It like does not much damage. Keep in mind, if you use El Thor and you want to get out of the gigantic hole you just made, electric step out. Electric step has a really low cooldown. Oh, and that's a Poneglyph, by the way. Yeah, that's a Poneglyph. The fourth move, we'll actually need an entity to use it on, but like, I'm not gonna do that. It's basically this electric field that's there, and it just kills like a lot of entities around us. And it has such low cooldown. El Thor and this move, very low cooldown. Now, it's time for the fifth move that I'm using like this. Which, it's kind of like El Thor, but mini version. Like a mini El Thor. And now we have the most powerful move, this Raikou. Now, the yellow bar is the build-up. As soon as the yellow bar here is done, if you're using Raikou, run. Or else you'll be trapped in a hole that's this big. Yeah. Raikou is the most powerful move. Now, for the seventh move, if I click it, nothing happens. The reason for that is I will need the Tomoe drums. For those who watch One Piece, you might recognize this. Now, I'm wearing the Tomoe drums. F5. I Voltamaru. This, what you see here, really powerful. You can also fly with it. I'm flying. And if the cooldown is up, you turn back into a normal person. Yeah. Gorogoro is OPOP. Speaking of OPOP, that's the next clues we're gonna use. So if I slash kill, I just need to go here. OPOP. OPOP is actually kind of mid in this game. So we have room, shambles, tact, ejection shot, counter shock, MES, gamma knife. Now most of these fruits are actually really good, except some of them can be really bad, like the Hito Hito Nomi. I don't know why that's even in the game. Okay, this is room. It's really huge. Shambles. Tact. For to actually activate tap, need to press it again. This is that needing a sword. I don't have a sword currently. This did something. I think it's a really strong move. Six. Also another attacking move that you can't see because there's no entities near me. And then seven, gamma knife. This is the most OP one. And then I just need to remove shambles and boom. It's gone. Yeah, I told you. Not too good. One more thing about this mod. Not only do we have the devil fruits that are just completely random. We have the mini Nomi. I don't even know which. And then you might think, oh, this is the Mira Nomi, aka fire. No, it's the Netsu Nomi, aka heat. And this is fire, which is also Logia. Weapons. We have very little weapons, with Murakumari being your strongest. The scissors are used with the Kage Nomi shadow to take people's shadow. Equipment. We have drip. Many character drip. Look at this. I just take this. I have a Doflamingo. I take, let's say, full on Sanji. And this is how I look. It's cool. It looks super cool. And it gives us so much armor. And we also have these. We have like road poneglyphs and these like small decorating items that builders would love. It's really cool. A belly pouch. This is the Devil Fruit Encyclopedia. And character creator. So, with that, I am saying bye. Hope you all enjoyed the video. And please, check out Mino Nomi.